Welcome to Contact. Today we're continuing our series, Don't Accept Defeat. This is our third message, and today we're going to be talking about tuning your ear.
Yeah.
So, defeat, well, you know, our ears can hear a lot of things.
Yeah,
so.
Jesus had a lot to say about that, which we will talk about, but what it really comes down to is actually doing that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, learning how to hear the Holy Ghost, listening to the Holy Ghost, getting yourself in a place where you can hear Him.
Right. So hopefully we're going to have some tips about that, because this involves us in being involved.
Right.
It's something that we have to do. It's not something that's going to be done for us.
Right.
You know, so I like that thing about, you know, you have to get on the machine for you to actually get the exercise. So we're going to learn about how to tune our ear today. Stick with us. We'll be right back.
Bring your friends and loved ones this Christmas season to Faith Landmarks Ministries for a Christmas play you won't forget. Celebrate the most spectacular birthday party ever held on Earth and renew your mind in what the real meaning of the season is all about. Join us for this special one-night event, December 15th at 7 p.m. at Faith Landmarks Ministries. For more information, you can visit our website at faithlandmarks.org, 8491 Chamberlain Road, Richmond, Virginia. Big Night RVA will be here before you know it. Open to youth and young adults, come out this December 20th at 7 p.m. You can find out more about Big Night RVA by going to our website at faithlandmarks.org. Are you looking for a church that's active, engaged in outreach, and based on the biblical foundations of God's Word? If so, then Faith Landmarks Ministries is not only that, but much more. For over 35 years, Faith Landmarks Ministries has been teaching the Word of God, training up disciples, and expanding the kingdom. Through the fivefold vision God has given to Pastors Randy and Cherie, we make it our mission to fulfill the great commission that Jesus commanded in His Word. We invite you to come worship, receive, and fellowship with like-minded believers every Sunday morning at 8:30 and 10:30 a.m., Sunday evenings at 7 p.m., and Wednesdays at 7:30 p.m. Check out our website at faithlandmarks.org and view recent messages, see upcoming events, download study materials, and much more. You can also stay connected with us via any of our social media services. We invite you to come experience real, undoctrinated Christianity, where the Word of God is brought to life in you. We look forward to seeing you here at Faith Landmarks Ministries.
Welcome back. Just really glad that you're with us. This is turning into a really powerful, connected type of a series of messages. So we're talking about not accepting defeat in life before people get to know the Lord closely.
Mm-hmm.
Defeat becomes something that people really work at learning how to manage and so forth. So what we're pointing out through the whole series is that there's another way to do this, and that God wants you to turn to Him in the middle of some sort of a bad situation that would otherwise be defeat. And it's astonishing to realize that He will have a completely different take on it.
Right.
And it'll actually end up being an opportunity to start something new.
And I have a very practical example that just came up in my spirit while you were talking about that, about defeat, because, you know, the percentage of people who have been filing for bankruptcy has just been really huge in recent times.
Okay.
And, you know, it's like, you know, well, I don't see any way they're out of this problem. I don't see how we're going to be able to pay our bills. We can't make ends meet. The only thing we can do is just throw in the towel, you know, destroy our credit and file for bankruptcy. And I remember that we had a very close relative that was facing this situation. They had almost looked like insurmountable bills, and the budget didn't line up of the income that was coming in the amount of bills that they owed, and they had a house that they were thinking, well, we're just going to have to give this house up and let it be taken over because, you know, it was not where they were working and it was too far to drive and gas was $4 a gallon. And, you know, and you just look at this scenario and it was looked pretty impossible. But we said, don't do that. Don't be defeated. Don't take bankruptcy. There's got to be an answer.
Yeah.
So we, you know, we went into our prayer closet. They went into their prayer closet. And the Lord spoke like in the answers in the desert.
Right.
Because you went into the cave. You separated yourself to listen to how can you get out of a situation like this.
Right.
And the Lord gave clear direction.
Right.
And specific answers that right. really released. And then what happened
yeah.
was a miracle happened from that because, you know, they were able to get a buyer for their house.
Yeah.
But not only were they able to get a buyer for their house, but they were also able to, they received a large sum of money to be able to start a business that had been a dream, you know, what you right. desire.
That's amazing.
And then now, you know, several years down the road, they're actually living out their dream.
Yeah.
You know, with God having met the desire of their heart.
And that same house ended up being the fulfillment of a dream for somebody else that's now living in that house.
That's right.
Yeah.
And that was supernatural.
Yeah.
Someone who didn't think they would ever be able to own a home.
Right.
Because of the defeat that they had had in their life. It was like
previously,
their yeah. life was sort of at a standstill.
Right. So we could spend quite a bit of time going through just without
stories,
mentioning
names
but people that we've known over the years that have been faced with defeat,
mm-hmm.
but rather than accepting defeat, they decided to go this direction that we're talking about.
And look to God for the answers.
And God bailed them out.
Yes.
You know, he bailed them out.
Because he still works miracles.
Yeah. So today we're talking about tune your ear. And one of the things that Jesus said over and over again, he made this statement, he that has ears to hear. Now, you know, frankly, every person sitting in front of him when he said that probably had ears on their head. But he knew that, no, just because you can listen to something doesn't mean you're going to hear it.
Right.
So he was really talking about, when he was talking about hearing, he was talking about hearing God's word and getting it on the inside of you, getting it in your heart is what he was really saying.
Yeah, that's just hearing like the steak is on the table. You can smell it. But then you can eat it,
yeah, right.
and you take it in,
you get the
nourishment.
Inside, yeah, right.
And so I look, God's word is called bread.
Yeah.
Man shall not live by bread alone
but by
every word that comes from the mouth of God. So I look at, when I hear something from God, I just take it like food.
Yeah.
And then it goes into me and becomes a part of me. And
yeah.
when I need it, it comes up.
Comes back up again.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Right. So what this series, you know, when someone has a defeat on them, okay, what we're doing is laying out all of these principles that can come together like in a time compression
mm-hmm.
and form an understanding of, oh, well, there's another way I can go. You know, I just don't have to go with the problem.
That's right.
I can go with the answer. I can decide to go with the answer instead of letting the problem dominate. And so that's what we're doing. We're rolling out all of these things that form a picture for a person who has experienced a defeat. Sometimes, you know, defeats are like in slow motion.
Mm-hmm.
Other times they're almost instantaneous. You know, so like a family can have just a loved one coming home from work one day and they have a severe automobile accident that completely changes and disrupts everything in their lives.
Right.
Okay, but even in the middle of an instant defeat, which that is a defeat, instead of just going with, you know, what seems to be the obvious thing that's going to have to happen, there's a way that you can, start to turn it around. And you can actually shift the entire thing to a different outcome and receive what God has for you rather than what the defeat dealt you.
Right.
Yeah, so I'm going to read in a moment Daniel chapter 10, which is really all about Daniel's prayer life. But there's this phrase in the Old Testament that it pops up in the New Testament too, is how did that happen? You know, and so one of the things that the nation of Israel were always struggling with was, well, how did that happen? You know, and so one of the times in John chapter 9, Jesus' disciples were asking him this question about this blind man that was, you know, right, on the road, on the way with them. And what they were really asking is, how did it happen that this man was here? Now, there had been other blind people on the way with Jesus, like blind Bartimaeus and other ones. And so they're trying to read something into it that wasn't there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so Jesus said, well, it's not his sin or his parents. It had nothing to do with that, you know. But the answer to the question is, I've come to do the works of him that sent me. So, in other words, he healed the man like he did all the other blind people that, you know, were found in his way.
So hopefully they were tuning their ears.
Yeah, terrible things happen to people. They just happen, you know. So one of the most important things about not accepting defeat is don't try to read too much into it. You know, it isn't because...
I like to say don't take it personally.
Yeah, yeah.
Because bad things happen to everybody.
Everybody has bad
good
things
people,
happen.
Good people, bad people,
yeah.
In between people,
yeah.
Bad things just happen.
There's a simple answer for all of it. It's the devil, you know.
Yeah.
But that might not necessarily be the most helpful thing.
Right. So let's talk about things that are helpful to
the
do
answer, yeah.
When shocking things
yeah.
happen.
How did this happen to me? I don't really know. But we can turn that around so that later you can look back on the event and probably have a lot more understanding of how it happened.
Well, the news media has got everybody so trained to, you know, anytime any catastrophe happens, you know, they're all there with their opinions
right.
and their answers and their
analytical perspective.
Analyzing the whole situation
yeah.
with their spin on it. And, you know, it just... sometimes it just aggravates me, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's why I don't like to listen to the news, but or, you know,
especially believe it.
Well, but, you know, because we're talking today about tuning your ears.
Yeah.
So, you know, I remember back when when we started having the financial collapse, with the economy was going down, and we had this house at the river, and we bought it. It has one of those little TVs, like Leave It to Beaver, you know, in the kitchen of the family, with a little TV hanging from the cabinet. And I thought it was so cute, you know. And we had the cable, you know.
Yeah.
And so it's the only place, you know, where I even had time to do something like that. And so I'd be in there cooking and cleaning the kitchen, and I'd turn on the TV, and there'd be, you know, I thought, well, I'll listen to the news, you know, one channel and then the other channel, you know, the other voice, and there are different voices, you know, and it started really upsetting me. I thought, are we going to have a depression?
Yeah.
You know, is the whole thing going to collapse? And the stock market was going down, and, you know, and the church had money put aside in, you know, in investment funds, you know, to be good stewards over it. And, you know, I just remember going, you know, is everything going to collapse?
Yeah.
And so I just clicked. I just
turned it off, yeah.
And everything was so much better.
Right.
And so I was able to listen,
mm-hmm.
tune my ear
right.
to, you know, what God's promises were about taking care of us financially and all of these things, so we wouldn't have to accept defeat.
There we go.
But if I'd kept that TV on...
as the only source of information.
I would have swallowed everything they had to say and allowed that in my heart.
Right.
And then I would have started behaving and acting out of that fear and that information instead of acting out of what the Bible says.
Right.
So off went the TV.
Yeah. And as a matter of fact, what we did with exactly what you're talking about is we shifted from the defeat. You know, it actually was not a defeat for us.
No, sounded like it
yeah,
was going to be
one. Yeah, but we shifted off the defeat and started really... you know, promulgating the answer,
right?
You know, which a lot of other people needed to hear.
Well,
too.
Actually, and during that time, when everything, the bottom fell out of everything, everybody was having a hard time. We built another building,
right?
$8 million.
Yeah,
and it's paid for.
Yeah,
I mean,
we paid for it during the great collapse,
the great recession or whatever. It was supernatural because we tuned our ear to what God had to say. He told us to build that building.
Yeah.
He told us to build it for young people to come and for their lives to be changed. And so it didn't really have anything to do with, the money in the bank or anything, because God took care of it,
right,
even when it looked like it was impossible.
Worst possible time. Yeah.
Yeah.
Amen.
So.
Hallelujah. Okay, so there's a model for us to follow. Daniel, in the Old Testament, as a prophet, he's a model of a person. He's actually in captivity.
He's a model of not accepting defeat.
Exactly. Right? So he's in captivity, but instead of woe is me and so forth, he's pursuing God about how they're going to get out of that mess. You know, so he tuned his ear to hear, so which is exactly what Jesus said to do. So here's an example. Daniel had a prayer life. I can imagine what it was like in heaven, because Daniel was actually, grabbing and pulling. It's just like a person falling off a cliff. He was climbing back up with his prayer life.
And that always got him in trouble. I mean, think about it. Mm-hmm. He was praying three times a day when it was his enemies made a plot that anybody that prayed going to have to be thrown into the furnace.
Right.
Death sentence. That's when they threw him in the lion. I'm forgetting about the other one with Shadrach.
Yeah, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
So Daniel just threw open the windows of his room and he knelt down to pray three times a day, right out in the open.
Yeah.
And so he got thrown into the lion's den for tuning his ear.
Right.
To hear what the Lord had to say.
Yeah. And so in response to his prayer life, the angel Gabriel comes from heaven and says, from the moment that you started praying, I was sent with the answer, but I've been having this trouble with the prince of Persia and
the devil.
The devil.
Exactly. The devil was fighting the answer from God.
Exactly. So I'm going to read the scripture reference to you about Daniel's prayer life. Daniel chapter 10, verse 12. Then said he to me, this is the angel Gabriel that we were talking about, "Fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that you did set your heart to understand and to chasten yourself before God," that this was his prayer life, "your words were heard, and I am come for your words." But then he goes on to explain in starting in verse 13, "I was having trouble in the heavenlies. That's what was detaining me."
Right.
So in other words, God was responding to him, and the people that are watching this need to understand there is no such thing as the name of Jesus not working. Okay. But just like what we were talking about that financial collapse thing, there is trouble in the heavenlies.
Mm-hmm.
And it can take time for your answer to get to you. It doesn't mean that God didn't respond and it's not a defeat.
Right.
It's just it's a logistical thing. God has to be able to get to you.
Well, that reminds me of a prayer that we made. I talked about watching the TV at the River House. Well, that was something when our children were little, we were always busy and we didn't have time to have family time. And so I was coming back from visiting my grandmother and myself and our two children that at the time went by the place on the river that I had grown up in the summers with my family's little cottage on the river. And we went down on the beach and I showed it to them and they just loved it. They just thought it was great. And I said, why don't we ask Jesus to give us a house here? It was like sentimental to me because I had grown up there my whole life.
Right.
And so that was the only place I knew. And of course, they didn't know any different either. So we said, here on this beach. So we held hands on the beach and just a simple little prayer. We said, Lord, we need time for our family. We just ask you to work it out because we didn't have any money in the savings account. We didn't have anything, but we didn't know how much those houses would cost or anything. But we just asked the Lord to give us a house on that beach. So then forgot all about the prayer. A few years later,
yeah,
you heard the Lord say the same thing. You need time for your family. And so we decided to go looking around. And when we did, I said, well, let's go look at that place. You know, I'd forgotten all about it. While we were walking up and down the beach, the man who was about to put his house on the market heard us talking.
Yeah.
And he had already gotten his for sale sign for my owner already. And he heard us talking, so he ran out and stuck it in the ground.
Right in front of us.
Right in front of his house. Yeah. And we came back up to get in the car, and we said,
and he's pushing the sign in the ground.
There's a house for sale right there.
Right.
So we went, and it was on that beach.
It was two doors down from the one you grew up in.
Right. And so we walked in, and he showed us around a real little tiny place, but you know, we just said, we just believe God's going to give it to us. We wrote a deposit check for $1,000 for the contract.
Yeah.
Now, here's more of the story.
Right.
I still forgot that we had prayed that prayer.
Mm-hmm.
So we were in a service where a prophet was ministering, and he stopped in the middle of his service, and he said, the Lord wants to do something for the pastors. I don't know what. Maybe they need a new car. I don't know. I think it's something big, but I don't know. He just wants to bless the pastors. And so we're going to receive an offering right now for the pastors. And in that offering was about a third of the payment for that whole house. I mean, a third of the house.
Yeah.
And so we just knew what it was for. And when we, you know, just closed on the sale and walked into that house, the Lord reminded me that we had held hands and prayed and asked to have a house on that beach.
Right.
So it didn't happen immediately.
Yeah.
I didn't even remember the prayer.
Yeah.
I mean, that's how faithful God is, because we just trusted Him. And I could put a prayer into my prayer, Heavenly Father's prayer basket, and
boom.
He fulfilled it in His time.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So we're talking about hearing from...
Tuning your ears.
Tuning your ear in. And it does involve, like Daniel is, like we said, it's like a model.
Right.
And Jesus talked about it. He that has ears to hear, let him hear. Jesus talked about getting into your closet and closing the door.
Right.
Which is another way of saying, you know, to tune in to God and turn everything else off.
Kind of like a modern day cave or desert.
Yeah,
go to your closet.
I'm getting alone. Yeah, I'm getting the impression that for people in today's world, they don't really, they haven't had the experience yet of turning off voices.
Mm, okay. So important.
Yeah, and so, you know, you don't have to manufacture something from God. All you have to do is just turn everything off and put yourself in a place where there's nobody that can get your attention but Him.
Like when you're flying on the airline, they tell everybody you have to turn off your electronic devices or put them on airplane mode.
Yeah.
And so today, the big thing is everybody has their Bible on their phones and their iPads, but I see people receiving texts and things. While, I mean, it's only 30 minutes to hear, you know, what the Lord is saying to the congregation, but yet there's
in church
their phone is blowing up because they didn't put it on airplane mode, which means no disturbances, because I'm going to take this dedicated period of time and not have any other input.
Right.
Distractions, because you can't hear two things at the same time.
No.
So if God wants to talk to us, we have to be able to tune out all the disruptions and interruptions so that we can hear what He has to say.
Amen.
Yeah. So don't go away. We'll be right back.
Bring your friends and loved ones this Christmas season to Faith Landmarks Ministries for a Christmas play you won't forget. Celebrate the most spectacular birthday party ever held on Earth and renew your mind in what the real meaning of the season is all about. Join us for this special one-night event, December 15th at 7 p.m. at Faith Landmarks Ministries. For more information, you can visit our website at faithlandmarks.org, 8491 Chamberlain Road, Richmond, Virginia. Big Night RVA will be here before you know it. Open to youth and young adults. Come out this December 20th at 7 p.m. You can find out more about Big Night RVA by going to our website at faithlandmarks.org.
At FLM, our missions efforts have always reaped a harvest of souls into the kingdom and touched the lives of countless people across the globe. We take the commandment to go into all the world seriously and are always looking for new areas where the gospel can be sown. God has led us into two new fields where we can further impact the world for Christ. In Jacksonville, Florida, we are helping Dr. Terry Horn and his wife, Cynthia, to reach the children of the inner city by supporting their Metro Kids ministry. Just recently, they were able to lead 40 children to the Lord and bless everyone who came to their outreach with food, toys, and the love of God. We are also branching our missions efforts out to Moldova. Located in Eastern Europe, just south of the Ukraine, Moldova is a country hungry for the Word and looking for support to grow and establish a strong Christ-centered presence in the region. Your giving helps to accelerate our efforts to those like us to see the Word of God sown into every heart and mind across the earth. Sow into missions today and watch as God multiplies your seed sown.
Open to children from 6 months to 4 years, Faith Landmarks Child Development Center is dedicated to having your children prosper under a loving Christian covering. Visit our website at faithlandmarks.org and enroll your child today.
Welcome back. Really glad that you're with us today. This series is turning out to be a life changer. And so I want to say to you that being the case, this is, we just finished with number three. There'll be four of these, and you can go on our website, contact.tv, which you'll get the information there in the lower thirds, and you can podcast, download all of this for free, or you can actually buy it to have it come to your house and use it in your car and so forth.
I just want to encourage you, don't give up. Don't give in. Don't accept defeat. Don't accept negative outcomes for the dreams that you have in your life. If you will take the time to get alone with God and just open your heart to Him, even maybe journal. I journal to the Lord all the time. But, just so I can write it down and relook and go back and see how He's answered prayers. So I'm just suggesting that you do the same thing and let Him speak to you because you've tuned your ear to Him. Glad you were with us today on Contact, and we'll look forward to seeing you back next time.